Welcome back to another .NET MAUI Beginner Series video. I'm James Montemagno, a product manager on the developer community team here at Microsoft, and today we're continuing our journey building native cross-platform desktop and mobile applications with .NET MAUI. Now, previously we learned what .NET MAUI is, how to install it, and everything that's in a file new project. Next up is actually creating user interface and taking advantage of all the different layouts and controls built into .NET MAUI. And we're gonna build a small application that is a to-do list that enables us to keep track of all the things that we wanna do, and also how to update our user interface when the users interact with it. So let's hop over to Visual Studio 2022 and get started. This is the application that we're gonna build. It's called My Tasks. Here on the home screen, we'll be able to enter a task, click add, and add it to this list. This is gonna be a collection view, which is a nicely optimized list display that enables a whole bunch of new features and grouping capabilities. So we're gonna check that out today. Now, as of current, our application looks like this, because all we've done is created a brand new .NET MAUI application. Now, what's great about the template is that it's fully responsive. So here we have light theme and dark theme, and you can click to increase it, which is absolutely awesome. All right, let's go ahead and turn this into My Tasks. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is go ahead and head over to the code. Now, this is the default template. So here we have some images, some labels, and the button. Now, what we're gonna do is delete all of it. Now, we actually don't need a scroll view here, because if you remember from the photo, this down here where it says apples, bananas, and oranges is gonna be a collection view, and that already scrolls. So what we're gonna use in the base is gonna be a grid. I like grids a lot because they are rows and columns, and I can kind of put that into my head that here there'll be three specific rows: the image, the enter tasks and add button, and then the collection view. There'll also be two columns. Here we're gonna have kind of a column for enter task and then another one for the button. And both the logo and also collection view will span both of them. All right, well, we've deleted all the code, but we also wanna take a look at the code behind here, this main page XAML CS. Now this code behind, at one point when we did file new, represented some interactions with the main user interface. So we're gonna go ahead and delete those because we're not gonna use those button count clickers there. So let's go ahead and delete them, and I'm gonna hit debug. The reason I'm gonna do that is because I'm gonna start building my user interface directly with XAML hot reload, so we can make changes and see it update in real time. All right, so our application is launched. It's a blank screen now, and all we have is a grid. Let's go ahead and define those different rows and columns. So I'm gonna say row definition, and the IntelliSense helps me out here. I'm gonna say 100, those are gonna be density pixels that'll automatically adjust based on the resolution. For the second row, I'm just gonna use auto. That's just gonna tell it to use as much space as it possibly needs for the controls. And then the last row, or row two, so 0, 1, 2 of index 0, that one's gonna fill it. All right, we're also gonna use the column definitions. And here again, there's gonna be two columns. Now, if I wanted them to just size themselves, I could say auto, auto, but I kind of want them to be a little bit different size. In fact, I want the first one to be 75% of the second one. So I'm gonna say 0.75 star and 0.25 star, and that's gonna give a ratio of 75% and 25%. All right. Now, so far, we still don't see anything because we haven't put anything in it. All right, the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna put an image in here. So let's put an image, and then I'm gonna go ahead and say grid dot column span. So it spans both columns, set it to 2. And then source here, well, we don't have any images in here yet, but we could use that .NET bot under resources. So .NET underscore bot dot PNG. So let's go ahead and put that in there. .NET bot dot PNG. I'll go ahead and close that tag. And sure enough, there's .NET bot. Hey, .NET bot. Now what's great here is that I could also set the background color if I wanted to see what exactly is filling. So here we can see it fills the entirety of it, which is pretty great. And it's directly in the center as the default. I like that so far, but we can see that it's actually filling every single corner, which means that everything is gonna be filled. So let's go ahead on this grid and put a padding. And I'm gonna put a padding of 10. As sort of a little inset here. So .NET bot is a little bit inset and not hugging that home bar. All right, next up, we're gonna put in an entry. So here's an entry, and I'm gonna put in a placeholder. An entry is a text entry field, and you can do all sorts of great things like make a password and things like that. The placeholder here will be enter task, and I'm going to make sure that it is at grid.row equals 1. There we go. And I can say, hello world. Now, the important thing to note here is that the automatic default is 0, 0. So I didn't need to define grid.row or grid.column on the image because it's already at 0, 0. Same thing here on the grid.column on the entry. I didn't have to enter it because it defaults to 0. I could still put it there if I wanted to, totally your choice. All right, let's add a button here. So now we're gonna add a button. I'm gonna set the text to add. And now we're actually are gonna set that grid.row to 1 and grid.column to 1 as well. We'll close the tag, and now our button's there. Now you're probably saying, James, wow, those things are all really close to each other. Now I could add margin to each of these, and margin says, hey, stay a little bit further away from me, but built into the grid are actually row spacings and column spacings too. So here we go. When I say 10, 10 and hit save, we can see that now we get a little bit more space there, which is great. All right, next up is gonna be our collection view. So this is gonna be a way for us to hold a bunch of items. So I'm gonna put in a collection view, and here we're gonna say grid.row2 and grid.columnSpan2 as well. And we're gonna go ahead and open this up because we're gonna put some things inside of it. The first thing that we're gonna do is give it some hard-coded data. And this is just so we can design the user interface. Later on, we're gonna fill it in with real data. So whatever we enter adds it to the collection view. So here we're gonna say collectionView.itemSource. And then what we can do is fill it with an array. Now this is one of my favorite features because you can just actually say x colon array, and that'll create an array in the XAML. And here I can say, hey, array, please be a string. So now we're gonna create an array of strings. So now I can put my string in here and I can say apples, and then go ahead and copy these. And I'll say bananas, and I'll say oranges, and hit save. Now what we can see is that apples, bananas, and oranges totally showed up, which is great. And of course I can fix my typos too. And now we have all of our collection view totally good to go. Now, one thing I want to note here is that they're not looking super duper great because it's just going and using the default template, which is just a label. And that's what it's doing here for the string. So we can go ahead and give it something called an item template to spice it up a little bit. So here we go. Underneath the item source, we're going to say collection view dot item template. We're going to be doing some data binding here, and we're going to get into it a little bit more in our next video. But what it means is I want to take these apples and say, please use that inside of my item template. So by default, we'll use a data template here. And then what we can do is put in, let's say, a label inside of it, maybe inside of a nice little card view frame, and we'll be good to go. So the default I'm going to use here is a grid, and I'm going to give it a little padding of 0, 5. And inside of that grid, we're going to give it a frame. And then what we're going to do is give it a label. And what we're going to do is create a label that is text and that has a binding to dot, which says bind to myself. When I hit save here, we're going to see that we have apples, bananas, and oranges. And we can also set that text to be a little bit bigger. So let's say font size 24, for example. Now we're talking apples, bananas, and oranges, and everything resizes for us automatically. Now we're able to add our new items here, or will be in a little bit, but what if we wanted to delete them? We could add a delete button. We could try to like click on one, but what if we could also swipe to delete? That sure would be nice. Well, dotnet MAUI has that all built in. What we'll do is we're gonna wrap this grid inside of a swipe view. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna say swipe view. There we go. And what that does is says, please put everything inside of this grid into a swipe view. And then we'll add some swipe items. So I'm gonna say swipe view dot write items. You can do left, top, or bottom, but we're gonna do right. And then I'm gonna give it a list of swipe items. Now you can have completely customized swipe items, but I'm gonna use the one that's built in. And this enables me to set text like delete and a background color of red. I'm gonna go ahead and save again. And now we can see that we have delete right there. Look at that. That's awesome. Very cool. All right, well, we still don't have our image fixed up, so let's go ahead and remove that orange. Now we're back to transparent. Let's put our logo in there. So I'm actually gonna stop debugging for this. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into our resources images, right click on add, and then do existing item. Now over on my desktop, I'm gonna select all files and I have my logo.png. So now I've added it in here and we can see it referenced. And what I can do at this point is come in and say logo.png. Now I'll go ahead and recompile the application. And what this will do is take that resource and automatically recompile it to display it inside of my application. Now this time, it's not gonna be as quick. It may take a few additional seconds as it compiles up those resources. So let's give it a few seconds here. All right, our application is launching. And now what we see is the My Tasks logo right there. I can now come in, enter my tasks, enter a task. And soon we'll be able to actually add it to the list and get rid of that hard-coded data. And that's what we're gonna do next when we learn how to use MVVM and data binding inside of the My Tasks app that we just started to create. All right, and there you have it. We've started to build out our user interface completely in XAML. And again, this is just one of the options that developers have when creating user interfaces with .NET MAUI. You can also create your user interfaces directly in C#. And there's a great community toolkit, in fact, the .NET MAUI community toolkit, which is built by the community and supported by Microsoft, that has a whole bunch of great .NET MAUI goodness in it, including C# markup extensions that help you be even more productive when you're building user interfaces with C#. I'll put links in the show note below. Now, since we are building our user interface with XAML, it comes with great developer productivity features like data binding, which enables your UI to automatically react when you update code in the code behind, and vice versa. When you update code in the code behind, it will automatically update your user interface. So next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and start using MVVM, Model View View Model Architecture, and data binding to update our application to be reactive and responsive. So stay tuned for the next video.